What's going on, golf addicts? Welcome to Tour Junkies After Dark, presented by DK Sportsbook. We are the Tour Junkies. I'm DB. I got Pat Perry with me. This is Tour Junkies After Dark. It's late on a Monday night. We just finished recording our own previews for the Palmetto Championship 2021 from Congaree Golf Club in Ridgeland, South Carolina. Brand new golf course, new venue, new host, new tournament, replacing the Canadian Open. So it's interesting. A lot of unknowns, a lot of stuff going on. Be sure and go ahead and hit the thumbs up, hit the like button, hit the subscribe here on the DraftKings YouTube channel if you haven't already. It's going to be a good show. Trust us, you'll like it. We're going to talk a little bit about the golf course, what's going on with that, and then we're going to talk about some outright bets that we're seeing on DraftKings Sportsbook that you may want to look at right now before the lines get any shorter. You know, it's U.S. Open qualifying week. You got a lot of people withdrawing at the moment. We're recording this late on Monday night. So we do know that as of now, guys like Charlie Hoffman, Brendan Grace, Danny Willett, Siwoo Kim, those guys have all withdrawn. DraftKings doing a good job keeping the pool updated, but you definitely need to jump on some of these numbers before they get shorter so that if we hit a winner, we hit it big. Pat Perry, talk to me a little bit about Congaree Golf Club and your week at Congaree, where you're going to be credentialed media on site.
Yeah, it's amazing. They saw me fit to actually provide credentials. It's crazy. But yeah. Congaree Golf Club, just outside of Savannah, Georgia, Hilton Head Island, whatever. I mean, it's out in the middle of nowhere in Ridgeland, South Carolina. But it is supposed to be a fantastic course. As a matter of fact, it is ranked in the top 100 in the world, even as new as it is. It is a Tom Fazio designed. It is par 71, playing almost 7,700 yards. So can be a beast of a course. It is Bermuda grass tee to green, which we typically see in South Carolina in this area. So I'm interested to see what this course looks like on TV. I'm going to get an in-person view of this course. I'm going to be walking the course tomorrow, which is going to be Tuesday. So I cannot wait to get out there and actually see how this course plays, because I think you're going to hear a lot about this course this week. A lot of people are going to be reading things from folks who have played it maybe in non-tournament conditions. And, you know, we know it should probably be playing firm and fast. There's a lot of long par fours out here. There's a lot of slopes around these greens, and that's kind of how it was designed. But how is it really going to play? I don't know. We'll see. So looking forward to getting out there and preaching. I'm going to show people what the course is all about and telling you about it. So that's it.
Yeah, I can't wait. So follow along with us, the Tour Junkies, on our channels, on our website, on our social media channels, Twitter at @Tour_Junkies, Instagram as well. Pat will be on site delivering the goods. You know, it's a weak field, really weak field. Everybody's kind of punting this week, ready to go on to the U.S. Open, but it's a great opportunity, especially with some of the inside intel that we're going to be getting from our caddies and tour players on the ground with Pat, that, you know, you could take advantage of that and make some money and have a bigger, you know, bigger bankroll to spend for the U.S. Open. So I'm excited about it. And we'll be back next week for the U.S. Open. Should be a great show. Should be a good time. Pat, let's talk about the outright numbers that we're seeing right now. As of now, on Monday night recording this, we don't have any top 10s or top 20 numbers from DK Sportsbook, just outright numbers. I'm going to give you four names total tonight. Four names. Kind of in the mid-range, because I'm honestly not interested in the shorter range. DJ's not playing great. He's not playing great at all. He's here probably because he's the stereotypical South Carolina guy. Who knows what Palmetto's done to get DJ to come here. You got Brooks, who is clearly, he's always been a play the week before a major guy, kind of figure it out. He admitted that he did that at the Byron Nelson a couple weeks ago when he was at the PGA. I mean, what's he been doing? He's been hanging out at the Logan Paul Floyd Mayweather fight. Like, Brooks is out. And then with a field like this, it's just, it's a long shot tournament. Like, a long shot's going to win this thing more than likely. It's golf. It's highly variable. I don't think it makes a lot of sense to bet the top end of this board. So I'm going to start with Harold Varner III, still looking for his first official PGA Tour victory. He's at 35-1. Now, he has won the Australian PGA Championship over in Australia, but he's never quite closed the door on the PGA Tour. He's had some good finishes, had some top fives, had a runner-up a few weeks back at the RBC Heritage at Harbortown, but he checks a lot of boxes. Approach play, around the green play, off the tee play, all in the top, you know, fourth, top 10, 15% of this field. He's up there. He just can't putt. So if HV3 can deliver some putts, he's a southeastern guy. Like, if he can deliver some putts on this Bermuda grass, I think HV3 could close the door and get his first PGA Tour victory at 35-1. Now, listen, none of these guys' names and outright numbers are going to feel great. Like, you're going to have to kind of hold your nose and click send because the field is so weak. So we're used to betting HV3 at 70-1, 100-1. That just shows how, you know, not great the field is. My next bet in this shorter to mid-range tier is going to be Keith Mitchell. He's currently at 46.5-1 on DK Sportsbook. Mitchell's a stud. He hits the ball a long way. He's a PGA Tour winner. He won the Honda a couple years ago, 2019, I think. Very difficult golf course. He's contended a lot on tough golf courses, most recently at the Wells Fargo at Quail Hollow. Basically just got outran a little bit by Rory McIlroy. Keith Mitchell's a Sea Island resident. Right here near you, Pat, down there in Savannah, mm-hmm. Probably as a Georgia Bulldog, as a Sea Island resident, as kind of a southeastern guy, like being, 40 minutes away from Congaree and a top 50, top 100 golf course in the U.S. He's probably played Congaree. He's at least seen it. I think Mitchell's interesting at 46.5-1. So those are kind of the first couple guys I got. I got two more, but I'll let you go first.
Yeah, I'm actually with you, too. I'm not really liking a lot of these guys on the shorter end, and I think this is a sweet spot right in here in this 45-1 kind of range. I like Mitchell. I'm with you there. I also like Garrett Higgo. He's another guy that's been pretty popular lately as far as when you look at his European Tour stats recently and his history. He has been playing really well, won a couple events. We hear a lot of good things from some of the players and caddies that talk about him. Apparently, he's just a fantastic player, and he is definitely a rising star. So Garrett Higgo, you're getting at 46.5-1. Obviously playing here probably because he's going to be in the U.S. Open, and he's probably just trying to get warmed up, but I think he can also win. So I think Higgo here is a good play. And I was with you on Keith Mitchell, by the way. And then I'm going to have to get a little bit longer. I mean, really, those are my top names there. I like Rafa Cabrera-Bello. He's at 85-1. He's a guy we've been seeing play very well recently. He had a stretch for a while, really last year, where he just was terrible. But his game's coming around. He's had some good finishes lately. I think in a weak field like this, he can be even better. We saw him play he just hasn't put like four really solid rounds together, but he's getting some decent results recently. So I like him at 85-1. And then one other guy, shorter than 100-1 that I'll throw out here is I'm going to give you Ben Martin at 85-1. He's another guy that we've seen play well recently as well. So I like Ben Martin, 85-1.
Okay. I don't mind some of those guys. I got one triple digit number and I got one more kind of mid-range guy, and I'll button it up. My mid-range player at 60-1 is Brant Snedeker. I mean, Brant's, he's an old timer. He's kind of an old guy now on the PGA Tour, but we've seen old guys play well. It's an old guy season. He had Stuart Sinks won twice this PGA Tour season. He just had Phil at 50 win the PGA. But Snedeker's checking boxes in this field in the last 24 rounds. He's 16th in strokes gained approach, 21st in strokes gained around the green. He's always been a great scrambler, really solid putter. Definitely puts better on POA than maybe he does Bermuda, but overall, he's a great putter. And he hits a lot of fairways. And then when you look at his recent finishes, I mean, Snedeker's been playing quite well. Ninth or sixth at the Valero Texas Open, 11th at the Valspar, 17th at the Byron Nelson. And that's all since April. Snedeker's a PGA Tour winner. In a field like this, given his form, given his ability to get hot with a putter, I think 60-1 is an interesting number. I think it's a good value compared to a lot of other numbers that I see here. And then finally, I'm going to round out my betting, my outright card, with a rookie on the PGA Tour and a web.com or Korn Ferry Tour stud in the last year or two. Vincent Whaley at 110-1. I am a huge fan of. I've been talking about him a lot. I love me some Vincent Whaley. Okay. He checks a ton of boxes. Approach play, around the green play, putting on Bermuda, strokes gained off the tee, all in the top 30 to 25 in those categories. Vincent Whaley playing great so far in his young PGA Tour career. His best putting surface by far has been Bermuda. He's coming off a top 20 at the Charles Schwab, 26th at the Byron, 26th at the Wells Fargo, 29th at the Valspar. Like, he's knocking on the door. There's not a lot of gap between a 26th place finish and a win, especially when you consider the strength of field that he's seeing in those other events versus what he's seeing now. At 110-1, this could be a breakout victory for a young star, possibly in the making before our very eyes here on the PGA Tour, Vincent Whaley at 110-1. And if you don't like that number, you know, wait till DraftKings drops the top 20 numbers and maybe bet him as a top 20.
All right, well, I'll add a another guy that's not necessarily a rookie on tour because he's on the Korn Ferry Tour, but that is David Lipsky. He is at 125-1. He's a guy that has been playing incredibly well on the Korn Ferry Tour. He's got several top five finishes over the last month or so, and over the last year has been playing really well. He's a good ball striker. He's top 10 in this field in strokes gained approach. Also a good scrambler as well. Not particularly long off the tee, but as I said, when we're talking about the course, I don't necessarily think you have to be, even though it's a longer course, you don't have to be a bomber to play well in this course. So I think Lipsky is a decent play there at 125-1. In a field like this, you never know. A guy that's, you know, had a lot of success on the Korn Ferry Tour, he can certainly come out and maybe win this week. So there you go. That's all I got.
Love it. Good stuff. Yeah, it's going to be one of those events where we're going to learn a little bit this week. You know, new course, interesting field, week before a major. It's hashtag learning season this week. Mm-hmm. So pay attention to what Pat's got going on. He'll be out there on the ground. Should be a good time. Give the video here a thumbs up if you don't mind. We'd appreciate it. And yeah, let's have a great week. May your screens be green over there on DraftKings. We appreciate DraftKings Sportsbook supporting this show. Hope you guys hit some winners. Let's hit a winner this week. I'm pumped about it. I'm feeling good about it. Let's hit a long shot. Let's hit a bomb this week. I think that'd be fantastic. Okay, let's do it for the Palmetto Championship at Congaree. Thanks for watching. See ya.
Out.